I guess you're watching this video because your computer is running with an issue here as you're trying to open a program you have recently installed. This error arrived. The program can start. API whatever .dll is missing from your computer, or the code execution cannot proceed. API whatever .dll was not found. These are the exact same problem and it has a same solution as well. Hello everyone, welcome to Tech Evolution. In this very short video, I'll be fixing this. Before we proceed, let me thank you for your amazing support in my previous video. Consider subscribing to this channel if the video helps you. Enough with the intro, let's get started. The first method is to download the DLL and place it. In order to move the DLL, you need to first open your favorite browser, then go to Google and search for the entire file name, the .dll. You can choose whatever the result you want. In this case, I'm choosing the first one. This video is not sponsored, but I'll put the link in the description. Here you can see a download option. Before we download, let's check our Windows version. If you don't know, click on start and search for system information. Now you can see mine is a 64-bit PC, so let's download this. I strongly recommend you to read this page. It has other fixing method also. As the download completes, hit open. Inside the downloaded DLL, you can see the DLL file. In order to move the DLL, first open this PC, then local disk C, Windows, and find a folder name system32. Then click on the downloaded zip, drag the DLL and drop, and click on continue to give administrator access. Before we go ahead, let's check if the file is placed perfectly. By typing the entire file name, you can see the file is placed in 32-bit folder. So job is done for 32-bit users, so you can go and restart your computer. This is the summary of 32-bit users. This is only applicable if you are a 64-bit user. You need to open this PC one more time. Then local disk C, Windows, and find a folder name syswow64. There it is. And similarly, drag the DLL and drop. Click on continue to give administrator access. Check this one more time. By typing the entire file name, you can see the file is placed in 64-bit folder as well. And finally, restart your computer. This is the summary of the full process for 64-bit users. Every computer is different. In some special cases, if the error still occurs, you need to go back to the website where I show you some other steps and you can follow that. I hope you don't have to do this. And that's all. If you follow me step by step, so you no longer have that problem left. If you need my further assistance, consider giving me super thanks. And don't forget to give your feedback. And do not forget to like and subscribe. Hey, why don't you watch my other videos? Thank you for watching.